Hi guys, today I will be showing you how you can access your NAS drive's photos, music, and videos that are compliant file types from your Windows 7 PC's DLNA setup and streaming devices. I did my initial recording for this video with Windows 10, but switched back to Windows 7 because the symbolic link functionality behave differently with the folders being populated in Windows 10, but not the files. As a result, I made sure to note that this works for Windows 7. Also, if you're interested in knowing how to create your own custom M3U files from sites like archive.org, etc., with TV and movie links, then subscribe to be notified when I post my how-to video, creating your own quasi-time machine channel and XTV-like Roku content. In that video, enter my subscribers giveaway for classic TV fans, providing a one-on-one M3U playlist setup and SanDisk wireless flash drive. So let's get started. First, you will need to configure your PC to be a DLNA media server. The required steps are: from the Start button, type in Media Streaming option. Then, turn on Media Streaming. Next, navigate to Media Programs and make sure Allowed is selected. Click OK. Finally, navigate to the Windows Media Player or type in Windows Media Player from the Start button. Next, maximize the player, and on the third line on the top left-hand corner, select the stream drop-down menu and make sure Automatically Allow Devices to Play My Media is selected. Now, validate that your PC is showing up as a DLNA server from your streaming device. You will need to create at least three symbolic links, which will be virtual Windows directories to access your NAS videos, music, and photos, pointing to your applicable NAS folders. The My Video folder is located in /users/yourloginid/videos. The My Pictures folder is located in /users/yourloginid/pictures. And the My Music folder is located in /users/yourloginid/music. You will need to use the fully qualified NAS drive name versus a map drive. I'm calling my main virtual folder ReadyLink, but you can call it whatever you would like. The required steps to add your NAS links to your local My Videos, My Pictures, and My Music folders are: first, decide which NAS folders you want to access via your DLNA server for videos, pictures, and music. Next, create a folder called ReadyLink in each of the three local libraries. Then, open the command prompt as administrator. I'm going to configure two NAS drive folders to be scanned for videos and populated in the My Videos folder. I will configure my NAS folder called Photos to be accessed from my local My Pictures Library folder and my NAS folder called YT_songs_2018 will be accessed from my local My Music Library folder. The basic syntax is mklink/d followed by either your local My Videos, My Pictures, or My Music folder name, then / main virtual directory name. I'm using ReadyLink. Then / and the last subfolder's name. Next, input your fully qualified NAS folder directory that you want to be mapped. Here is an example of what a successful link creation looks like. Here are the ReadyLink folders that I manually created without links. So now, let's run each of the mklink commands from my Windows 7 PC. As you saw in my setup, I decided to have the first DLNA folder mapping pointed to my entire NAS drive, and the others pointing to specific folders. The larger the number of directories you include in your virtual directories, the more time it will take for your folders to be scanned and the file links to be populated. Now, I'm going to pause the video, and once the links are populated, continue. Depending on how big your defined virtual directories are, it may take some time for the DLNA folders to be fully populated. You can see the progress in the Windows Media Player showing its refresh activity. All right, so let's navigate to the NAS video folders from within my streaming device. You will need to first select video from the main screen. Next, click on your PC's DLNA media server, then click on Video. Then Folders. You can also select the All Folders. Then Videos. And finally, ReadyLink. Now, navigate to your desired DLNA compliant NAS video file types. And voila, there you go. You will need to do similar navigations for photos from pictures and audio from music in the main screen. You can also access these NAS files via the UPnP DLNA servers from phone apps. Please note, after updates, you will need to exit out of your streaming device's channel or app, then come back in to see the update. You can trigger an immediate update or refresh to your DLNA server after NAS changes from the Windows Media Player. Select the drop-down menu Organize, then Apply Media Information Changes. It may take some time if you have large virtual folders. If you are still not seeing your change after 15 minutes, you can delete, then recreate the virtual link. You can delete a link by right-clicking on it and selecting Delete. I've found that the Rokus can be very picky when playing files at times, given a corrupt file message, even though the same file plays fine on your PC and other streaming devices.
Hey guys, so if you found this video helpful, then give it a big thumbs up and subscribe.
Thanks for watching.